गुड मॉर्निंग. लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेस पॉडकास्ट विद फ्री फाइव फ्री नेचुरल लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग कोर्सेज फ्रॉम टॉप यूनिवर्सिटीज लाइक स्टैनफोर्ड, बर्कली एंड सो ऑन. सो डेटा साइंस ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूज टू बी ट्रेंडिंग टॉपिक, बट मोर स्पेसिफिकली NLP इज इंक्रीजिंग इन डिमांड बिकॉज NLP इज अ सबसेट ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड मशीन लर्निंग दैट हेल्प्स computer understand, interpret and manipulate the human language, where it has many applications including speech recognition, automated chatbots, sentiment analysis and so on. Speech recognition is something like it's Siri, Alexa, something, whatever the human is talking to that particular device, it will come back again. Best example is Google Assistant and Siri, Alexa. Automated chatbots is something like if you are going to open some websites, it will automatically pop up in the right corner of your website stating that, hi, how are you, connecting to live agent, etc. You can talk naturally to that particular bot and get a correct reply from that bot, whatever the questions that you are asking to that particular bot. Sentiment analysis, I think you all know if you are into data science. So, from languages to information, that is Stanford University. If you are looking for an introduction to NLP, I think this Stanford University course is best for you because if you do not have any experience in Python language, go to tutorial points on Python. And this course covers the basics on text processing, sentiment analysis, information retrieval, chatbots and more. So I highly recommend this course if you are new to programming or know absolutely nothing about, you know, starting beginners NLP. So this course details is CS124 Stanford University from Languages to Information Winter 2020 course. And the second one is it's Natural Language Processing with Deep Learning. That is, it's also from Stanford University. So this course is also from Stanford, but it's little more advanced, no? But that is, first one is for beginners. That is, from Languages to Information is for beginners. And this is after beginner stage, you have to implement that through Kaggle or through lots of websites like Analytics with the Analytics Max, etc. Apart from this, if you are going to the another advanced stage, I think I would suggest this NLP with deep learning, you know, that Stanford University course. So it's also from Stanford, but as I already told you, it's a little more experience because you're expected to be more proficient in Python and have a good understanding of basic calculus, statistics and machine learning, and also it's a math heavy. So you have to know that if you are going to become a data scientist or a data analyst or a mathematician or a statistician or a AI engineer or bot designer or whatever may be the position, you have to know the basic statistics because each and every machine learning algorithm have a statistics knowledge behind that particular algorithm. So first we have to learn statistics, then only we have to jump up into a data scientist toolkit program. So you have to know a basic understanding of Python and R is mandatory. Apart from this, you have to know a basic understanding of statistics like mean, median, mode, chi square test, everything. I will publish a separate video on that, and also machine learning. So here in this course, what I'm trying to say is NLP with deep learning, Stanford University have, mainly they focus on math, a bit heavy on math, because when we are going to hands-on the training with deep learning algorithms, we have to know if we know the algorithm math behind that, then it will be easy to implement whatever the use case that is given from the customer. So keep in mind that big portion of courses focus on vectors, matrix, calculus and neural networks, because these concepts can make up the foundation of a lot of NLP concepts. So you do not feel like you have the mathematical skills required. So I recommend that you start with the first course above, then followed by this course. And all the course description links and all will be given in my description box below. And third one is Oxford University course, that is Deep Learning for Natural Language Processing. So as they have already quoted, this will be an applied course focusing on recent advances in analyzing and generating speech and text using recurrent neural networks. We will introduce the mathematical definitions of the relevant machine learning models and derive their associated optimization algorithms. And this course will also cover a range of applications of neural networks in NLP, including analyzing latent dimensions in text to transcribing speech to text, translating between languages, and answering questions. That means, similar to the second course, this course have a heavy emphasis on neural networks, so it's highly recommended because it's also have a very practical and application heavy. So you should be a proficient programmer to go with the third course, and as proceed with the third course. The fourth course is Natural Language Processing. That is from University of Washington, which is uniquely, this focuses on hidden Markov models, grammars, and then it also provides a very nice tutorial PDF like neural networks, practical assignments. Second one will be very interesting if you, whatever you are studying, if you are going to practice it, hands-on through Kaggle or coding or Google Collab or whatever may be the tool Google Collab is something like whatever you are going to implement it through the interpreter to that tool. It will be very interesting whatever we have learning. Theoretically, that is fine, that is good. But practical implementation is, I think, needed for data science. And going with the fifth course, Apply Natural Processing UC Berkeley course. So, it's a graduate PACA course that is quite extensive. So, it will use the sklearn library, Snicketlearn, Keras, Denism, and Spassy. So, these are all the Python libraries. So, they do not share any assignments or practical or any quizzes. You have to actually put your own knowledge on this. And these topics include text-driven forecasting and prediction using text for problems involving classification or regression. Then experimental design. Then the representation of text including features derived from linguistic structures such as parts of speech, name entity recognition, and the features derived from low dimensional representation of words, sentences, and documents, etc. So these are all the five important first courses. I will tell you the name again. It's for beginners, From Languages to Information, Stanford University. Second course is Natural Language Processing with Deep Learning, Stanford University. Third one is Deep Learning for Natural Language Processing, University of Oxford. Fourth one is Natural Language Processing, University of Washington. Fifth one is Applied Natural Language Processing, UC Berkeley course. So these are all the five, data science, NLP course from foreign universities. So if you get this, you will get the recognition from foreign university, the certificate, that name will also be there. And also you will learn NLP. So you have 2+ in this. So the course description and all, I will give the code and also the link if possible in my description box below. And I'm planning to post statistics, machine learning algorithms, then deep learning, the data visualization. These are all my next upcoming ideas that I have to publish my video. So these are all my five important domain that I am going to focus on. Statistics is very important, then only you can go to Python or R. Then after Python or R, you can go to machine learning algorithm. After that, you can go to visualization. Then you can go with advanced algorithms, advanced hybrid algorithms, and chatbot, deep learning, auto ML, that and all you can try at the last. First, this is basic. If you pass in basic only, we can go with that advanced things. So these are all basic things. So I will give you a plan for 2021 and 22, how to make use of this algorithms and become a data analyst or data scientist or machine learning engineer, whatever may be the position you are going to. So thank you so much. Keep subscribing, and I am happy that we are reaching 1K subscribers soon. So without your support, it's nothing. So thank you so much, and keep subscribing.